I'm very pleased to address the China-Pakistan Political Parties Forum and third meeting of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor Political Parties Joint Consultation. I extend my heartfelt gratitude to the political leadership of People's Republic of China for continuous support, which has been instrumental in deepening bilateral cooperation and making China-Pakistan Economic Corridor a great success. Excellency, I would also like to say that your coming to Islamabad and presence here also is a testimony of the relationship that Pakistan, the unique relationship Pakistan and China enjoy. First of all, I would like to extend our heartfelt appreciation to Chinese leadership for hosting the Prime Minister of Pakistan during his recent visit. It is pertinent to mention that the leadership of the two countries has complete consensus on bilateral matters during the meetings of the Prime Minister of Pakistan and President Xi and Premier Li. Both sides reached consensus to further strengthen our strategic partnership, enhance our economic cooperation, and revitalize an upgraded China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. The China-Pakistan Economic Corridor has significantly transformed Pakistan's development and promotes integrated growth. And I would like to place on record that the nation of Pakistan can never forget that the Chinese side came to the rescue of Pakistan when Pakistan was facing 18 hours of power shortages in 2013, and no investor was willing to invest in Pakistan. It was the political leadership's decision to ask Chinese investors to come to Pakistan and help Pakistan overcome energy shortages, and that billions of dollars of investment turned around the economic and energy landscape of Pakistan. And to just give you one example how it has helped Pakistan, for 70 years we had coal buried under our ground, which was enough for 400 years to give us our cheapest energy. We could not tap that resource. It was CPEC that helped us unearth coal as a gold for Pakistan to produce the cheapest energy for Pakistan. The China-Pakistan Economic Corridor has significantly transformed Pakistan's development and promoted integrated growth. To further this progress, both sides successfully held 13th session of CPEC's Joint Coordination Committee on 24th May 2024. And I had the unique distinction and honor of co-chairing 10th JCC meeting out of 13 held so far. Two sides agreed to upgrade CPEC with inclusion of 5 new corridors, as Your Excellency mentioned, including a corridor of growth, a corridor of livelihood enhancing, a corridor of innovation, a green corridor, and opening up regional connectivity corridor. Pakistan side appreciates vision of Chinese leadership to upgrade the second phase of CPEC with inclusion of these new corridors. I am very pleased to inform that these new corridors are in line with Pakistan's 5E's framework, which focuses on developing Pakistan's export potential, transforming Pakistan's economy into a digital economy, focusing on environment, climate change, water, food security, fixing Pakistan's energy sector to give us affordable, efficient, and green energy, and promoting equity and empowerment in our society. We are ready to work with our counterparts in China to define the scope and implementation plan on these corridors. Both sides are highly committed to this shared vision, and together China and Pakistan have embarked on a journey of shared dreams, working hand in hand to build high quality development projects. And I must also say that the new phase will bring immense opportunities through business to business, cooperation, industrial cooperation, relocation of industry to Pakistani SEZs, our partnership in agriculture, bringing new and modern technology from China to enhance our productivity, bringing our cooperation in sectors like science and technology, information technology, and above all, China's readiness and willingness to share its development experience in the spirit of Chinese wisdom, where it says, don't give your brother a fish, but teach your brother how to catch a fish. Excellency, as we meet today, the geopolitical landscape is marked by uncertainties and complexities. The rise of protectionism, trade wars, and conflicts pose significant challenges to our world and our region. In this context, it is imperative to underscore the importance of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor and showcase it to the world how it serves as a beacon of stability and shared growth and prosperity. CPEC epitomizes the spirit of regional integration and economic interdependence. It shows how collaboration, rather confrontation, paves the way for sustainable development for overcoming the challenges we face today. CPEC enhances our strategic connectivity. The development of Gwadar Port positions Pakistan as a critical node in the regional trade. This port provides China with direct access to Arabian Sea, facilitating trade and energy supply routes as an alternate route for trade through land. And it is for this reason, Excellency, that the enemies of CPEC are working overtime to sabotage this project. But our determination and our friendship is far stronger than the designs of the enemies of CPEC, and we shall together defeat them and make CPEC a model of success. CPEC cannot be viewed in isolation as a bilateral initiative, but as part of a broader vision for regional prosperity. It has the potential to foster economic cooperation with neighboring and regional countries, contributing to regional development, prosperity, and stability. It creates a win-win scenario that transcends bilateral relations and promotes a more inclusive regional growth. Excellency, Government of Pakistan is aware of the security-related challenges to CPEC. This great bilateral initiative has been a target of propaganda as well as physical attacks by the enemies of both China and Pakistan. The Government of Pakistan has taken a number of measures to ensure foolproof security to Chinese personnel working in Pakistan. And I want to tell you that every Pakistani thinks that each Chinese national working in Pakistan is their national guest, and their security is more important to them than their own security. And we will not let any effort go in making sure that we provide the best possible security to all the Chinese national who are working in Pakistan. In the end, I would once again like to extend my sincere gratitude to you, Excellency, as a great friend of Pakistan, for your visit to Pakistan and to Chinese leadership for their continuous support and unwavering commitment to high development of CPEC. And let me conclude by saying that we have always said that the China-Pakistan friendship is higher than Himalayas. On 30th of May, I was at Chinese Space Station witnessing the launch of Pakistan's MM-1 satellite on a Chinese rocket. And when that Chinese rocket went into the sky with roaring noise, my heart said that today China-Pakistan friendship has transcended the heights of the skies. It is no longer higher than mountains. It has now reached the heights of the skies. Long live Pakistan-China friendship. पाक चाइना ताल्लुकात के हवाले से पाक